Hi, this is Mark Besser of Besser Healthcare. In this video, I will discuss human papillomavirus or HPV, HPV testing, and its treatment, and our recommendation on how and where you can get tested. Either you want to know for sure if you are HPV free, or if you think you have HPV, with fast, affordable, and 100% discreet or confidential testing. The human papillomavirus or HPV is the most common sexually transmitted infection, and there are more than 100 strains of the virus. Some HPV strains go unnoticed and seem to cause no symptoms at all, while others can cause genital warts or various cancers. HPV is so common that nearly all sexually active individuals, both men and women, will get a strain of the virus at some point in their lives. According to the CDC, approximately 79 million people in the United States have HPV, and an estimated 14 million Americans contract it each year. The human papillomavirus is most often transmitted during vaginal or anal sex, but can also be contracted during oral sex. Typically, HPV clears or goes away on its own, but it can cause genital warts or certain cancers when it doesn't go away. HPV strains that cause genital warts are not the same strains that cause cancer. HPV genital warts. Genital warts are small bumps or clusters of small bumps that appear in the genital region. They can appear as just one or many across the area. Genital warts can vary in size and shape from round or flat, big or small, or even in the shape of a cauliflower. Nearly 360,000 people in the U.S. get genital warts each year. HPV and cancer. HPV can cause certain cancers, especially cervical cancer, in women. The virus can also cause cancer of the vulva and or vagina in women. In men, HPV can cause cancer of the penis. Both genders can get anal cancer or oropharyngeal cancer that can affect the tongue, tonsils, and pharynx. Women should get screened for cervical cancer from age 21 to 65. According to the CDC, nearly 11,000 women get cervical cancer each year. There are immunizations available for both sexes for some cancer-causing strains of HPV. Cervarix is a series of three vaccines that is for females ages 9 to 25. It is used to prevent HPV strains 16 and 18, which have been linked to cervical cancer. The immunizations are scheduled in a 0, 1, and 6-month pattern. The second vaccine is received 1 month after the first vaccine, and the final vaccine is received 6 months after the second vaccine. Gardasil is an HPV vaccine that is also a series of three immunizations and is for both males and females ages 9 to 26. This immunization prevents four types of HPV strains, 6, 11, 16, and 18. The immunizations are scheduled in a 0, 2, and 6-month pattern. The second vaccine is received 2 months after the first vaccine, and the final vaccine is received 6 months after the second vaccine. Gardasil is used for the prevention of certain vulvar, cervical, and vaginal cancers in females. In males, Gardasil is used to prevent genital warts. In both sexes, Gardasil is given for the prevention of genital warts caused by strains 6 and 11, and the prevention of anal cancers caused by strains 16 and 18. Cervarix and Gardasil do not provide protection against disease from other strains of HPV or strains that an individual has previously been exposed through sexual activity, including the strains vaccinated for. If a dosage is missed from either Cervarix or Gardasil, the vaccination process must start over, so be sure not to miss vaccines. Also, it is crucial to finish the entire series to prevent the strains of HPV these immunizations include. Genital warts or abnormal pap test, also called a pap smear, results are the most common ways people find out that they have HPV. A pap test is a test done to look for abnormal cells of the cervix and uterus. HPV can change healthy cervix cells into abnormal precancerous cells. If left untreated, the precancerous cells can become cancerous cells. Some individuals find out they have HPV after developing an HPV-caused form of cancer. HPV and pregnancy. When developed during pregnancy, HPV treatment of the mother is often delayed until after delivery of the baby. HPV can cause genital warts to grow, and sometimes genital warts can grow even larger due to pregnancy hormones. If they grow big enough to obstruct the birth canal, the baby may have to be delivered via cesarean section. In very rare cases, a mother can pass HPV to her baby during childbirth. A tiny number of these infants develop a condition that causes tumors to grow in the throat called recurrent respiratory papillomatosis, or RRP. These tumors are surgically removed but often come back. Mothers with HPV can breastfeed their babies. Testing methods for HPV. There is currently no test approved to test for HPV in men, and there is not currently a test for HPV of the throat or mouth. Nucleic acid amplification, or NAA. HPV high-risk DNA detection. Detection of high-risk type HPV DNA sequences in female exfoliated cells or swab or tissue biopsies. The test provides qualitative molecular detection of 13 different human papillomavirus high-risk types, 16, 18, 31, 33, 35, 39, 45, 51, 52, 56, 58, 59, 68 without differentiation of the individual type. HPV treatment. There is no treatment for the human papillomavirus itself, but the conditions and diseases it causes can be treated. A doctor can treat genital warts. If left untreated, genital warts may go away on their own, remain the same, or enlarge. Cervical precancer or precancerous cells can be treated. Treating precancerous cells is easier and more stable than treating cancer itself. This is why routine Pap tests are essential. HPV-caused cancers can be treated in their ways, depending on what type of cancer they are. Cancer types are easier to treat when caught early on. And now, onto our recommended HPV and other STDs screening company. Click the website link listed in the description below this video to see the list of their test centers in your area with the discount coupon. Or go to bessercare.com/STDcheck. Our recommended HPV and other STDs screening company makes getting tested for STDs a simple and convenient process in just 3 steps. Step 1. Order their STD10 test panel or individual tests online or by phone. Step 2. Choose one of their 4,500 test centers nationwide. Testing only takes minutes. Step 3. Your test results are delivered in your online account within 1 to 2 days. The entire process is fast, affordable, and 100% discreet or confidential. Remember, either you want to know for sure if you are HPV-free, or if you think you have HPV, you need to get tested as soon as possible. Don't delay. Thanks for watching this video. If you like this video or find value from it, please click the like button and let us know what you think in the comments section below. Or if you have further questions or want to share something with us in private, please feel free to reach out to us at mark@bessercare.com. And if you want us to include a certain topic in our next videos, please let us know in the comments section below or email us. Also, subscribe to our channel and click that bell for you to be notified of our upcoming videos. See you again in our next videos. Stay safe and healthy, everyone.